Water is a major component of food and influences the texture, appearance, taste, and also the potential spoilage and disease-causing microorganisms in that food item. There are two basic types of water analysis. One is moisture content, and the second is water activity. Moisture content is the total amount of water present in the food, whereas the water activity is the measure of the energy status of that water that's available in the product. It's a very good indicator of the relative activity of disease and spoilage causing microorganisms, and that's why we measure water activity. Here are some key points to keep in mind. We know that microorganisms cannot grow in a product with a water activity of equal to or less than 0.85. The allowed cottage food products must have a pH level of equal to or less than 4.6, or a water activity of equal to or less than 0.85 to qualify as a non-potentially hazardous food. Sugar is used in things like candies, frostings, fruit pies, brownies, jams, jellies. And what that does is tie up or bind the available water to lower the water activity to equal to or less than 0.85. Items that are high in fat and also the use of salt are used to control water activity. Drying, roasting, baking are also methods that help to evaporate moisture to lower the water activity in a food. And if you're controlling for water activity, all ingredients of that product must be at a water activity level of equal to or less than 0.85.